By the end of this video, you'll understand the pros and cons of the Solidify modifier and an alternative operation to get the same results with more precision. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about the Solidify modifier. I frankly wasn't going to cover it, but I know that it's used so widely within Blender, and I just wanted to make sure you understood why I don't personally use it in my builds, and how you could use it if you want to. Starting from a fresh Blender file, let's go ahead, select everything and delete it, and bring in a plane, because we're about to take a look at the Solidify modifier. This is a modifier that can be very useful in the correct instances, however, I personally don't use it that much, and I'm going to show you why. I wasn't going to cover this one because I feel like it doesn't really deserve to be in precision, but I know that some people feel like they can swear by this, so I'm going to go ahead and show you it and show you my alternative, and then you can make your decision from it. So ultimately, we know that in edit mode, if we go into our face orientation, we have a 2D bit of mesh here, which has an outside and an inside. This is the normal positive, this is the normal negative. The reason why I'm going through this basics is because, quite frankly, we now go ahead and select it in our face. We're going to extrude it by 1 millimeter, and it goes up 1 millimeter on the normal, the positive. Now let's go ahead and do the Solidify modifier. Now remember that if you haven't done modifiers before, I really think you should go to the first video and then jump into this. All right, so here we're gonna go, Solidify. You might not see it because we're working with our millimeter precision. So let's go ahead and give it some thickness. Let's go 1 millimeter. Okay, it's gone ahead and done that whole idea of extrusion that I explained, but it's done it on the minus. Why is that? Well, like I just said, it's going off by the normal and it's gone on the negative of the normal. So if we set this offset to a 1, it goes on the positive of the normal. So if we want, we can set this to 0, and then it uses the normal, the center point of the normal, as sort of the point where to go 0.5 on each direction. All right, so that fundamentally is the Solidify modifier. Now let's go ahead, let's step this up a gear. Let's go ahead, let's bring in a cube, and let's go ahead and delete these two faces right here. Now with these two here, let's go in, bring in our Solidify once again. I'm going to go offset on the positive by 1 millimeter, and let's see what's happening. Right, that's not quite how we're wanting it, is it? It's going a little bit weird, funny, off shape. Well, what's happening here is basically it is averaging the normals. It takes the normals of everything in this shape and tries to average out this dimensionality. Well, for that, we've got this thing called even thickness. You tick this on and it's going to go ahead and say, yeah, I can go 1 millimeter every direction from the normal. You got it. I've got that. Well, let's just double check that quickly. I'm going to use CAD transforms. I'm going to go G. I'm going to go from the vertex from here on the X to the edge. Okay, great. That's 1 millimeter on the Y. That's great. That's 1 millimeter. However, does this apply to more complex geometry? Let's take a look. So that there is, again, fundamentally what the Solidify modifier is doing. So now let's get a little bit more complicated. Let's get an icosphere. Let's go ahead, select this face, use our numpad plus with control to select more, delete that. Remember all these crazy ways that I'm doing selection, all part of the whole course. There's a video for selection. So here we go. We have this right here. Let's go ahead. Let's add the Solidify to it. This could be a pencil pot for 3D printing, whatever you want. We're going to go on the positive because I wanted to make it bigger. Let's say 1 millimeter for now. All right, let's just go over some of the other settings. We know that we're wanting to go even thicknesses. Now, what's this whole rim thing? Well, the rim is this. This is the rim. So if we turn this off, it won't fill the rim. It will be like this. And if you want, you can say, hey, I only want that. Well, then it will remove your original geometry. Okay, let's go back. Let's turn off this fill because I do want to be able to see it. Let's once again double check the measurements that we're getting here because we're on simple. So let's see, we've got G. We're going to go from vertex to vertex because I think that's the easiest way. That's not correct there. Let's check once again. And that's not correct there. Right, that's not how it should be. Now do keep in mind there is a more intensive way to let this modifier work, which is using the mode of complex. And again, here we're going to go even, setting it to 1 millimeter as it was set before. And there's a whole bunch of other stuff here, but I'm talking purely in the terms of precision here. So you would expect if this was a 1 millimeter from here to there, it would be 1 millimeter. So let's go ahead, let's check that. So G, we're going to go from here to there. That is not 1 millimeter. From this point over here to there, that is not 1 millimeter. Maybe it's doing it from face centers. So let's go ahead and check that. So doing G, face centers, from this face center there to that face center there, it's closer, it definitely is. And if this is enough precision for you, by all means, use it. But for me, I like to know for sure that something from one point to another is going to be what I expect. And unfortunately, right this minute, we are at a point with the Solidify tool. I haven't found a way that it works for this, but there is a way of doing this. Unfortunately, it is not a modifier, but I will show you it now. So we're going to delete the modifier and we go into edit mode. So select the object, go into edit mode. We're going to select it all. I'm going to go Shift D to duplicate it, right click to cancel the move. And here we have it. Now, I'm going to tell you, we're going to be doing a scaling to get the thing that we're wanting. Now, you might be going, hey, but you never, the way that you taught me scaling is that it's very much set by this origin point or the points that is snapped here. Yes, but there's one more that I didn't tell you about because it is very much needs the whole context of normals and all the rest. So let's go ahead and do that. And that is normal scaling. So when you talk about a scale, a default scale is you hit S and it goes like that. If you hit 1, nothing is going to happen because the way that scaling works is 1 is original scale. Correct? Okay. Well, undoing that, let's go ahead, let's go Alt S, and now we have just turned on normal scaling. We're scaling along the normals. So now if you go ahead and type in 1, it is going to scale 1 millimeter, because that is our unit that is set in the scene, along the normal. So with that in place, let's go ahead, let's double check what we're getting here. So with our CAD transforms, G, you can see we're snapping from this vertex here over to that vertex, exactly 1 millimeter. Once again, we'll go from here, from this point here to that point there, exactly 1 millimeter. Now do keep in mind, we're talking with triangles right this minute, so there is no way that you would actually be able to go ahead, get 1 millimeter from each of these points, and also have 1 millimeter from face centers, because you need to also keep 1 millimeter from all the other points. We're getting into a little bit of geometry math theory here, but in essence, at least we have one number that we can fully confirm and understand what is going on, which is every vertex to vertex normal is going to be exactly 1 millimeter. And that there is how I go ahead and do the operation of a Solidify on more complicated geometry. By all means, feel free to use the Solidify in your own models for whatever you want, but I personally go ahead and do it like this. There are times that I do use the Solidify modifier to go ahead and just do a little bit of tolerance work, which you can see over in this video right here. But at the end of the day, nothing beats your hand editing of mesh to know exactly what is going on. Well done for getting through the Solidify modifier video. As you can tell, it's very much up to you. If it works within your precision workflow and those little margins of error aren't much of a problem for you, by all means use it. It can be a very powerful modifier. But I just needed to explain why I don't use it and how I need to know between point to point my exact precision distance, even if it means that I have to do it manually. There are other ways, using shape keys and a whole bunch of other stuff that I will cover in the future, but it's very complicated. And I just want to show you the fundamentals right this minute of how to get the same operation precisely. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and it's the main reason why I'm able to create these videos here for free for everyone. And if you're enjoying this video and all the other content that I'm creating, and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.